Those key points are made by engineering changing request engineering. Hello everybody and welcome to the Today Talk. Today we talk about the production workflow and how to speed it up with Odoo PLM. But first of all, let me start the standard PLM workflow. The standard PLM workflow is made by some key points that help us to better manage our product. Those key points are made by engineering changing request, engineering changing order that define the product from the beginning and help us to define the modification of our product. Then we have the CAE design that help us to produce bidimensional drawings, 3D documents, and also product and build material. Then we need an ERP system. The ERP system allows us to better manage the production. And then we need a tool that help us to manage the data from the CAD application to the PLM system to the ERP system. All these things have to work smoothly together in order to better manage our products. But now, have a look at the tools that we can find in the company nowadays. Most of the companies have a PLM system that define part numbers, products, bill of materials, documents, and engineering changing request, engineering changing order. Then we have the ERP system that get all this data and go to the production and deliver the product to the customer. Most of the time, we have a connector that transfers the data from the ERP system to the PLM system using web services or a text file or database table. All these things have to work smoothly together in order to do not lose any data. But the disadvantages of this system is that we have two storage systems of the same data. So taking care and synchronize it is not an easy task. Often, in some other companies, you can find some other tools to manage the same data. But of course, you do not have the PLM system. You do not have any connection with the ERP system and the PLM system. The data is managed in some Excel sheet, where the user put some part numbers or some build of material. Then they draw the build of material inside the ERP system directly by hand. This kind of way to manage the data is very bad because you can make a lot of mistakes. So have a look to what we have done with Odoo PLM and how we can avoid all the problems that you have seen before in the previous slides. First of all, have a look of the Odoo PLM solution. Odoo PLM is made inside Odoo. So you have with Odoo PLM, of course, you have Odoo with all the functionality of Odoo. You have a PLM system inside Odoo with all the functionality of the PLM system. So it means that we have just one storage for all our data. We have no synchronization because all the data that we produce is made in real time inside Odoo. So suppose that you create a new product. This product is directly inside Odoo and you can use it for the production. And of course, we have a scalable system because if you need more users, if you need more functionality, you need just to improve Odoo and everything is set up. So now we see deeply how Odoo PLM can improve your speed and why is better than the traditional system. As I told you before, the product are created in real time inside Odoo. So it's created in real time. It means that someone inside the company create the product is available in all the system, PLM and ERP. Then all the changing that you make in a product is reflected in real time. If you create a new field, this field is available in the PLM system and also in the ERP system in real time. So all the modification that you do in one system is reflected also in the PLM system. And also the same things that you can do with products can be done also with bill of material. So once you create a bill of material, the bill of material is available in the PLM system and also in the ERP system. But how can we do this with the Odoo PLM? We have developed a connector inside the CAD application that is able to read the data inside the CAD files and push this data directly in the ERP system using web services of Odoo. This made possible to create a strong link between the CAD application and the Odoo application. So all the change that you made inside the CAD application is reflected in real time inside the Odoo system. And this allows us to avoid all the mistakes creating products, create build of material. And also we are able to upload PDF of the drawings, of the CAD drawings. This makes also possible to share all the documents that the engineering department create inside Odoo. To better understand this process, we have created a demo for you. So let's see the demo. Hello everyone, here we are at the demo. So now we are in Odoo. First of all, what we would like to do is to create a new product, a new gear engine. And for this gear engine, we would like to discuss with our engineering department, with our marketing, in order to discuss and create our engine. So first of all, we create the product and then we create a new change request. This new change request, we need it's an extension of the activity Odoo, and we can schedule the user that is involved in the in our change. So first of all, we select the user CAD 1 and fill up the to check the specification of our part, and then we ask to the marketing department to check also this request to proceed. After clicking the progress bar, as you can see, new planned activity were automatically created in order to check and visualize our new change request. So first of all, we open the view, login as a marketing user. In this case, we see what the marketing user see inside the product. So going to the activities, you can see now we have two activities for today. One is for the hardware software and the other one is for the gear one. As a marketing user, I'm interested in my marketing check. So I edited and check if it's okay. And after that, I put in progress in order to inform my main administrator that I'm working on that. If it's okay, I can just put on the summary my information, and then lately I can say to Dan if I agree with the modification. So now I will go inside the main activity again, and I see that the activity for the marketing is set to Dan. So as an administrator, I can have the clear situation of my changing request. So now I'm logged as CAD 1 user. Also for the CAD 1 user, you see that there is a new activity to be done on the product, and now we have the gear engine 2. So I check the specification for this. I can add, in this case, a PDF document if I have one in this case. So I would like to add a new information inside the product. And I take a PDF just from my PC, and I just write a note in order to let everyone knows that I check the specification, and for me it's okay. So I put just this is the specification for tracing. So if anyone else want to see and check the specification, can do that. After that, I can also validate, because someone asked me just to check the specification, and set to done. So as you can see, the request is on the messages. And also, if I refresh the main page of the administrator, I can check, of course, the PDF document as Odoo let do. And then I can check my activity. What I see is that both go to done, and I can set the order. Now that my activity is in order, I can also assign some other PLM activity. In this case, I just set at the CAD user the activity to perform the drawings. So now I'm again as the CAD user. I check the activity if I want inside the web view, but the very interesting thing is that I also have the activity inside the CAD application. In this case, I just copy paste the name, and there is a tool that is this one, OpenAd Activity, that show me that that I have the activity to done. I just set it to progress, just to inform my administrator that I'm working on that. So I have my local desktop the file. I will go to open it, and then I can start to work on that. So I open the files, and then what I have to do is just to assign the data in order to save this file and all the build material inside the system. Odoo PLM allows you to just click on the saving button. This spreadsheet-like form will appear, and I can import the data. In this case, I import the part number that I defined before, and assign it to the assembly. Of course, I have other parts inside my assembly, so I need to create a new part to assign new data to all this part. In this case, I just put the description. I can also put the material if I want directly from this interface, and I go on setting up all the description of all the files. This is very important because I can just writing information on this form that is a view, direct Odoo view inside the CAD application. I can use Odoo to write products directly from the CAD application. So this is one-to-one connection. So each time I press the OK button, I perform a write operation inside Odoo. So I go on, assign all the data to the assembly. Of course, if I have other data that is already in Odoo, I can import for the other parts. So I go to or click the OK button, and the system will start to save each part, to rename each part, and assign it the name that of the file that is the same of the product name. This is very advantageous because I do not have to do it by hand, but I can do it by just clicking on the software. A pop-up message box will appear, tell me that the operation is finished. So now I can see the result of this operation. As you can see, if I refresh the page, I have the build material just created. And as you can see, the build material is composed by all the parts that was inside the assembly. Also, there are some shortcuts in order to see the files if I'm interested. And as with the Odoo standard tools, I can perform the operation. So now, if I'm a designer, I finish my work, I check it out the files in order to unlock the files so someone else can do the same, and can perform the workflow operation. So in this case, I just say that for me the job is done, and also I can close my activity. So I can go to the OK button and say that the activity is done. Doing that, I tells to all the administrator in this case that my job is done, and he see it because the activity is finished, and also the workflow is set to release, and also all the activity and is performed, and the activity stay in the activity sheet, and also the status goes to release. This is very important because I tell everyone that I finished my job, and for me this part number is ready to go into production. So what I can do now is to go to manufacturing, create new manufacturing order, and perform the operation directly from here. So I put the product and I create my manufacturing order. But in the meantime, I'm the manufacturing operator, and I see that something is wrong because someone forgot to assign the raw material of this part. So I don't know how, the material of this part. So what I can do in order to change it inside the system, I can inform my engineering department, just assigning a new activity, just a simple PLEGMA activity, in order to check the assembly and assign the material to other parts. So doing that, I can also use this method in case of some break of the parts during the first production, or other operation that I would like that my engineering department take care. So in this case, I just assigned to, assigned it to the marketing user, but it's the CAD user, the one that I would like to assign it. So now I assign to the CAD user, so I inform the CAD user there is something to do. The CAD user see again the task to perform, so in this case, he can just open the files directly from the activity. So he knows that there is that file, and I notify that that file can be changed. So what I do now here is just to create a new revision for the main assembly. So I just assign the new data, the new modification descriptor is available, and also it's available the capability to change the raw material. So I just change the raw material, I put inside the modification description, so the what is the meaning of changing a new version, and I check very easily also the sub parts of the assembly to see if there is something that is missing. In this case, also this part missed the raw material, and just I notify just that I change also this part, and I put the new material also into these parts. I can go on doing all the other parts in the real case, but this is not the case because it's just a demo. So I just work with this one. As you can see, there are others that miss the raw material, but I do not want to spend a lot of time to check every part just for the demo. So now I'm ready to save my assembly, so I can just save the assembly. This view it's a normal one, and I save the assembly. So now the assembly is updated as we did previously. I just check it in everything. I just confirm and release my job. I can set also the activity to done if I want or not, just to inform everyone. And then, as I told you, I can just put in progress and mark as done in this case. So doing this operation, I can go into the manufacturing order. As you can see, a new information appears that there is a new version of this. So I can just flag the automatically update MRP BOM and click the update BOM. As you can see, now I have version 1 and version 1 inside my production. So this is very useful because I can check my data, and I can update my manufacturing order very easily. I hope you enjoy, and see you soon.
Hello. Thank you, everybody. And thank you, Matteo. That was a great presentation and a great demo and walkthrough of your PLM solution. I've been familiar with your PLM solution being on the App Store for years now, different versions of it. If I remember correctly, you've had a PLM solution available long before Odoo developed their PLM solution. Yes. And to this day, what's that?
Yeah, sorry.
Oh, go ahead.
No, nothing. Sorry.
And I think it's probably good for people to understand the difference between Odoo's internal PLM and the one developed by Omnia Solutions, because they might have the similar kind of sounding name, but they're very different. And I think I speak for us when we say that your solution is a lot more advanced. It's the grown-up version.
Yes.
So real quick, one question asked by Timepiece Advisors is, this looks great, that's nice to hear. Is it available for Autodesk Inventor?
Yes. Okay. I start with the first one. There is a lot of differences between the one that Odoo perform and ours, because we start from the CAD application. So we build up an Arduino application that is able to interact directly with the 3D models and extract all the data and push it into Odoo. So from there, we manage all the files of the CAD application and everything's related. So we are a real PLM system. Odoo just take care of the modification of products and build material. This is something that you have seen here with what we have done with the task activities, but is more related to the tracing of the modification and why you perform a modification. And we are more near at the engineering department. So we try to solve all the trouble and problem that in normal engineering departments have in the companies. Most of the time, as I told you in the presentation, they have two separate software, one for managing the PLM data and the other one for the ERP system. With our integration, we do not need any more to have two solutions. You have just one software for everything. And this is the great advantages, and also they'll do kind of thinking of solutions. And yes, we are integrated with Inventor, ThinkDesign, SolidEdge, SolidWorks, and Autodesk. And the more is coming, I hope soon, but it depends sometimes.
Great. But that checks a lot of the boxes for the kind of requests that we often hear. The biggest one, I think, is usually SolidWorks, and second would be Autodesk. And integrating with SolidWorks for CAD, I think, is just such a huge value that you and your company can provide and bring. So that's great. It's great to highlight that, and I'm glad you did. Here's a crazy question related to that, and pardon my ignorance, but have you ever considered trying to create a SolidWorks replacement inside of Odoo, so a full CAD engineering platform inside of Odoo?
Not yet. It's too much to
be a lot.
Yes. What we have done is to embed inside Odoo a WebGL view, a 3D model that came directly from the 3D application. So you save the 3D files from the CAD application. We perform also the WebGL view for the 3D model, and we add it into the eShop of Odoo e-commerce. So you can have the 3D model inside the shop of Odoo. Yeah, we have done it.
That's nice. That's great. Yeah, people ask for that. Cool. I noticed you were using version 14. Can you talk a bit about compatibility for your Odoo PLM solution?
Yes, we started with version 6 of OpenRP, and today we migrated the first modules of Odoo at 15, and it works well. So I think in 2-3 weeks we are able to deploy our solution in full 15 versions. So we try to follow as much closer as it possible the Odoo versions.
Great. No, that's great. I think I wanted to ask just a couple general questions for you, if you don't mind, since we have time.
No problem.
You're based in Italy, correct? Where are you working out of? What city?
Yes, we are near Venice in Italy.
Oh, nice.
And it's a nice place.
So generally, what is the market like for Odoo there? What's the brand awareness like for Odoo? What have you experienced working from there?
Yes, it's here in Italy, it's growing a lot. And of course, starting with the version 12, there is a lot of changing on the Odoo. So it's more stable, more reliable. So it's easy to implement it. And it's just the fact that 2 days ago, I just worked with version 10 for a customer, and I spend a lot of time taking to update and so on. And then I say, oh, what's the difference? And so you can understand the difference. It's only if you go back and the old versions. And this is a very, very good point. I mean, and the growth of the system.
Got it. Yeah, I understand. Well, that's great. But I imagine that because of the uniqueness of what you offer, you probably end up with a lot of clients globally. Anybody that needs a SolidWorks integration, for example, probably is what.
Yes, we do not have only SolidWorks. We have other integration, and it's most likely the same. I mean, it's the divided maybe for all the integrations. And yes, we work worldwide. We work side by side with other partners around the world. Hmm. So it's up and often. And we take care only of our parts. Of course, here in Italy, we have customers that do everything, and we follow up also that sides.
Great. Well, thank you so much. That's it for our Q&A time. We will have a link on there for extended Q&A if you guys want to have just a one-on-one discussion. Otherwise, there should be contact information and ways to get in touch with Matteo. Matteo, thank you so much for your time and for all that you've given back to the Odoo community over the years. We really do appreciate it. And I hope you enjoy the rest of Odoo Experience, everyone.
Thank you very much, and hello to everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye.